Can you dig it, you sucker?
So there's one more story that you wanted to talk about where everyone said, man, Booker T sucks.
Man, Booker T sucks, man. It was the first time we went to Germany and Switzerland. And it was a huge tour for TNA, man. And I was excited. The one thing though, we had catering. You know, that was the second tour. We had catering. And I told all the boys, man, y'all can thank me for that. You know, y'all can thank me for the catering this time. And everybody's, yeah, thank you, Buck. Appreciate you, dog. But that was in 2009. And that's when everything was going in the wrong directions, just like the stock market right now with, you know, everything going on in the world with jobs. Everything, it seemed like the bottom was falling out of TNA at that point in time. We started out in Nuremberg and September 25th. And it was a show that was just, you know, a big building with, you know, no people in it. I don't know. We might have had a couple of hundred people in the building that night. And I remember going to one of the arenas, might have been the second night, and we roll in, and it's a big WWE sign right next to the building. Talking about coming to town and whatnot, like a week or so later after we was coming. And, you know, we did have a big crowd that night. And then we went to the next town, September 29th, Dortmund, Germany. And, that night was the night. And I was like, man, this night right here, we finna strike gold. I was talking to Mick Foley. You know, we was outside. You know, I was taking a little outside break. And man, it was people coming in from everywhere, man. I mean, the building was literally, it looked like 20,000. I mean, sellout house, man. I was pretty excited. Then we roll back in, get the show started. I get my gear on. And then I don't hear the people rumbling. I'm waiting to hear a rumble. And I go and look out the curtain, and I don't see, you know, those people that all those people we saw coming in. And the next day we know we could hear through the walls of the arenas, hey, ole, 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 ole. They was having a soccer match the next door, you know, on the same night. I was like, oh my God, you know, this is great booking. What the heck's going on here? So we moved to Hanover, Germany. And that show didn't turn out so great as well. Leaving from Hanover, we was going to Zurich. And Zurich, from Hanover to Zurich is 1 hour and 5 minutes by flight. Now, they wanted to take a bus and drive 10 hours, then take a flight from there to Zurich. For some reason, I don't know. And they wanted to take that bus for 10 hours. And I said, ain't no way in hell my queen, Charmelle, is going to be on a bus with a bunch of men for 10 hours. Okay? I said, it ain't going to happen. You know what I mean? Because men, they're disrespectful. They might break wind. They do all kind of stupid stuff and think it's funny. And I was like, ain't no way I'm putting my wife in that situation. And I refused. Right. It. And so I called the airport overseas and found out to take a flight from, you know, from Hanover to Zurich was less than $400, and it wasn't going to be but 1 hour and 4 minutes. We took the flight the next day in the afternoon, got to Zurich comfortably in first class, took a cab to the hotel, got to the hotel before anybody got there. The guys walked in literally a couple hours after we got there. Charmelle and I, we was in the lobby of the hotel. Now, they had been on a journey. I heard all kind of strange stories about that trip. No way I would have wanted Charmelle to be on it. And they walked in, and man, Jay Lethal and Awesome Kong. They looked like they had been through the ringer. They looked like they were. I said, guys, come over, sit down. Come sit down. They came to my table. We were sitting there eating breakfast. I said, brunch. I said, sit down, guys. I'll order you some meat. You know, so they sit down. We ate brunch. They was like, man, God, thank God y'all didn't do that. So I'm like, cool. Okay, now the show that night. Now this is the clincher. All right. I got 2 minutes. But this is the clincher right here. I've been a lot of shows. Normally we got security. If we don't got security, we got guys with shirts on that say staff. All right. I try to always peep out the situation, figuring out what's going on here, what's going on there. Now, in this situation, we're in the ring, Scott Steiner and I. We're going against Beer Money and Hernandez. All right. Now, okay. Okay, fine. Scott Steiner, he's a wild one. He's a loose cannon. Now, I normally do my shtick too, but I look around. I roll out the ring to mess with a fan, but I'm always looking for the security to, you know, to actually stand behind the security guard and talk crap. No security guard I can find. I look around and looking for the staff guys. No staff guys. Scott Steiner ripped the Swiss flag. All right. And next thing you know, beer bottles start coming into the ring. Beer bottles, literally glass beer bottles all over the place. Bing, 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 bing. And I got my queen. We got up out of there and we went to the back. All right. I remember one of the guys came back and said, book you and you're going back out. I said, no, I'm not going back out, man. You crazy. I'm the only black person in the country, probably. And, then Kurt Angle comes in. He goes, book, we got to go back out because Kurt was with us as well. And I say, Kurt, I'm done for the night. Took my tape off, and I did not work no more that night because we had no security, you know, taking care of us. And it was no way I was going to put myself or my wife back in that situation. Now, they hate me because I didn't go out and finish that match and put myself in that situation. But they, like I say, there again, they had zero security, and I just didn't feel like it was right or responsible to have us in a situation like that. And there again, I got a lot of heat from it. It's one story I didn't tell. We'll have to come back around on it. The infamous Matt Morgan story.
Oh, but, we gotta talk about that.
Guys, stick around and check us out. We'll be back on Wednesday night. But I appreciate you guys every time. Bradley, again, dog, appreciate you. We up out of here.